Hi, this is Dave with True Cable, and I'm here today to talk to you about how fiber optic cable is constructed. What I mean is, what is it composed of? Why is it composed that way? Why does it operate the way it does? We're going to maybe talk about a little bit of sciencey stuff. You might hear words like index of refraction and polyethylene, but if that bothers you, just ignore it. Stay tuned. We'll be right back and talk all about what's inside a fiber optic cable. To begin with, where all the magic happens is right in the center of the cable with a glass conductor. It's very small. It's up to 50 micrometers, also known as microns, in diameter. If you're wondering what a micron is, it's 1,000th of a millimeter. So you can't see it with your eye, but, well, it's really small. So that's where the light goes through. But we got to keep the light in there. Light can bounce around, especially when a light path changes direction. The next layer over the core is called the cladding. Cladding is also made of glass, but it's made differently so that it has a more refractive index. That just means that the light bends different in that other material. What that does is that turns the interface between the core and the cladding into a reflective surface. And that reflects back errant photons, you know, light rays that are trying to get out in the core. Well, it works for low angles of incidence. What I mean is, by low angles of incidence, here's a fiber strand that we're running a visible light through. And hopefully you can see that as we bend this more and more and more, lowering that angle of incidence, the fiber starts to allow light to escape. And that's showing up as a red light. With low angles of incidence, the cladding keeps the light in the core so it can go long distances. Cladding is covered by a coating because glass is very breakable and very fragile. Coating has two layers. The first layer is of a soft material that protects the glass from forces from outside, like lateral forces trying to crush the core. There's another layer outside of the primary coating, naturally called the secondary coating, and it is of a tougher material. And this material is to protect the strand from abrasion while it's being pushed to and fro. Those protective layers really form the outside of a strand. So this is a strand, and it's very fragile and not useful for installation on its own. The outer strand, the secondary strand, has a single color to it, and you can see that there are many colors available for making sure that you identify which fiber you're using in which case. In a cable, we need strength. We need to be able to pull the cable through pipe over obstacles. What's in this strand is very fragile. It can't be pulled, or it'll break. So there's another component to a cable called a strength member. And it's usually composed of fibers, Arabid fibers, also known as Kevlar. In some cases, especially in large multi-strand cables, it can be a fiberglass rod. In cable that is intended to be strung or hung between structures, there's a steel strength member, sometimes called a messenger wire. These are all various ways that the cable is strengthened so that you can pull it and install it and handle it without it being destroyed. These pre-terminated fibers, they come with a pulling apparatus. This pull ring is connected through this strap to the strength member in this fiber cable. So when you pull this through pipe, you are pulling on the strength member, and that's extremely important. One time I was pulling armored fiber across a big building, and I didn't know what I was doing, and the armor on the outside of the cable was really, really handy for grasping, and so we pulled that cable all the way across a warehouse by the armor, and we pulled about 30 feet of armor off the outside of the cable. And the person working up that TR, he said that he had to cut back about 30 feet of armor to find the fiber inside. So we got lucky that he could find it, I guess. We got lucky that we had a guy pushing the fiber off the reel instead of us pulling it off the reel. Bottom line is, always use the strength member to pull your fiber. Mm-hmm. outside the strength member and all that stuff is a outer jacket. And the jacket is what protects everything and provides any fire protection or weather protection that needs to be there. So some of the choices are polyethylene. Polyethylene is good for outdoor installations. It's very tough and provides waterproofing. It also provides protection from UV rays. So it's good for outdoor installations. PVC is used in both indoor and outdoor installations, and it provides pressure resistance and is very useful for situations where you need to run both indoors and outdoors. There's low smoke, zero halogen, which is intended to provide fire safety. And while talking about fire safety, we also need to talk about plenum cable. Plenum jackets for fiber are often made out of polyvinylidene fluoride. So if it burns, it produces no toxic gases. From core to jacket, hopefully that gives you an idea of what you're pulling on when you're putting in a piece of fiber. Like us and subscribe. Please give us your questions and comments. They are very helpful. In the meantime, if you've got a rock band or a racehorse or a spy novel that you need a name for, strength member.
Before the time runs out, if you enjoyed this video, head to our website below, check out our Cable Academy. If you're looking for some new videos, check them out next week. Thanks for watching.